are at the Villa Ariana. That's an elite Roman villa that was destroyed by the volcanic eruption of Vesuvius in 79 AD. This is the atrium, the core of the house. Decorated rooms all over the place. The peristyle garden, about the size of a football field. It was a fish pond, and it was right next to the kitchen over there. That terrace used to extend out to where we're standing now. The University of Maryland archaeological team is tasked with a comprehensive documentation of the decorated wall surfaces of this villa. Our goal is to get that documentation done before they continue to erode and become more and more difficult to conserve. We've been going to Stabiae for 20 years as an institution. There was an effort to excavate the large peristyle garden. It has evolved from that excavation campaign in the garden to a thorough documentation campaign of all the decorated interiors, which hadn't properly been done before. Documentation is every bit as valuable as the excavation.
The program takes undergraduate students as a study abroad class, and it teaches them architectural documentation, preservation, and archaeological processes. And it's a unique opportunity to get special access and analyze really closely the details.
And you can see the main lines, but there's something in the middle.
I was wanting to learn about the little floral details that are faded out.
So we have these medallions here, which are only present in this room in the villa.
When you look closely, like each little round door has a different figure inside, and then the birds can go from at rest to in flight.
It's astonishing to see the view and the building with the mosaics and the frescoes all together.
What they're trying to do at the end of the day is make a very detailed and accurate drawing of a particular wall that preserves some trace of fresco.
And you take a measurement.
To make that drawing, they use several different processes. First, they come to the site and they make a detailed hand drawing through direct observation.
And then we go back to site and we do like a more detailed measured drawing of it.
We run a LiDAR scanner, an electronic distance measure, photogrammetry.
And they combine the photogrammetry model and the LiDAR up to create visual document that is very accurate to the actual wall itself.
They integrate the information from their hand drawing with that measurement information.
And then they can create a realistic drawing of that wall, which then turns into a master document.
All of that goes together and integrates the best aspect of informed on-site visual observation by human beings with the best aspects from digital measurement done by machines. All right, everyone, gather around. So we've gotten to the really last stage of the process in wall documentation, field checking. So the whole idea here is to double check your work and make sure you're not missing the things that are interesting.
They had a slightly different red tone.
The documentation is very subjective. And so we have some architects on the team who will help the students learn where to focus more attention or exactly what to include and what to interpret.
Here, another couple of doubles as well.
So these are the guidelines that the fresco painter used to organize the compositions. This is a really good example of a wall that we need to pull out the interesting information in a drawing because it really doesn't show up in photographs. They do a lot of art historical learning as part of this program by being informed about the styles and techniques of wall painting and wall construction. They literally see more.
As you walk into an archaeological site, you're always kind of like, what would this have looked like? And the great thing about the Villa Ariana is it's pretty well preserved, and so you can kind of see what an ancient person would have experienced as they walk through the halls. But then as you emerge onto this terrace where you're meant to always look out at the bay, you're experiencing what the ancients experienced while also looking at a modern day city.
It's an indescribable feeling to be in a space that people used 2,000 years ago. It will never become less enchanting to feel the physical proof around you that that culture really was. That will never get old.
This documentation process has really highlighted the interrelationship between architecture and archaeology and art history. And the process of drawing all of these walls gives you that chance to both see the walls individually in detail and to study them as an artistic endeavor, but also to see the continuity of the entire room and then the entire space of the villa.
This was our final field season at Stabiae. This is really the beginning of a new wave of research on this site. The data that we're providing is meant to really be used by scholars around the world and be a catalyst